I had been calling them quarks most of the year, but I supposed it was probably spelled K-W-O-R-K or something like that. It seemed the right sound for a new particle that was the fundamental constituent of nuclei and so on, but I didn't know how to spell it. But then, paging through Finnegans Wake, which I had done often since my brother brought home the first American printing in 1939, paging through Finnegans Wake, I saw three quarks for Muster Mark. And of course it's quark, it rhymes with a whole bunch of things, mark, bark, and so on and so forth. But I wanted to pronounce it quark. So I invented an excuse for pronouncing it quark, namely that Humphrey Chimpden Earwicker, whose dream is Finnegans Wake, is the book, is a publican. In fact, later on I visited the pub in Mullingar. The Mullingar Pub it is, in, just near Dublin. And so a number of things in the book are calls for drinks at the bar. Of course, the words are multiply determined. They're portmanteau words, as in Alice. And the meaning's multiply determined. But one determinant is often calls for drinks at the bar. Three passe porterpease, for example, has something to do with three pots of porter, please. And so here I figured that one of the contributors to three quarks for Muster Mark might be three quarts for Mr. Mark. And it may in fact be true. But if quart is one of the multiple origins, then you would be entitled to pronounce it quark. So anyway, I put in the reference to Finnegans Wake. In the American edition, it's page 383, which is just perfect. In that first American printing, it's page 383, which is very good. 383 bar would be even better, but you can't get a page number 383 bar. So that was very good.